Hello students, in continuation with the previous lecture on lubrication, in this lecture we will discuss some principal classes of lubricants and their properties. One of its class is liquid lubricants or oils, which includes natural organics, consist of animal fluid, vegetable oils, mineral fractions, synthetic organics and a mixture of two or more of these materials. Various additives are used to improve the specific properties of these lubricants. Common industrial lubricants include natural and synthetic organics. These are the natural organics, these are the synthetic organics. Natural organics include the animal oils, vegetable oils and mineral oils. Whereas synthetic organic includes the different hydrocarbons, silicones, esters, phthalates and polyphenyl ethers and perfluoropolyethers. Natural oils generally include animal fats, which are nothing but the long chain organic acids, which are called esters or naturally occurring esters, and they are usually having good body lubrication properties, but they break down at elevated temperatures and they give sticky deposits, so they cannot withstand high temperature, not more than 120 degrees centigrade. So in comparison to that, mineral oils or petroleum oils are excellent body lubricants and they are most widely used, and they can withstand a maximum temperature of 130 degrees centigrade, and even super refined oils can withstand up to 200 degrees centigrade. So these mineral oils mainly composed of hydrocarbons, contains only carbon and hydrogen. So two basic or important types of petroleum hydrocarbons are paraffins, which are having straight and branch chain carbon atoms, whereas naphthalenes, which are having carbon rings in them. And of course, 2% of aromatics will lead to some sort of reduce in hydrogen atoms, but they will give aromatics. So these are the main types of petroleum oils: straight, branch chain, paraffins. These are naphthalenes with carbon rings, and these are the aromatics with 2% of the carbon aromatics, 2% of aromatics and reduced in carbonate. So the synthetic oils are in demand for their improved performance in aviation industries, because they can withstand extreme environments of temperature and pressure, high vacuum and high humidity. Especially they are less fire hazardous and they can withstand a temperature up to 370 degrees centigrade and 430 degrees centigrade for short periods, but they are little expensive than the mineral oils. The principal causes we have already discussed: different hydrocarbons and ethers, esters. So various lubricants and greases are used to provide the lubrication between the machine components, as well as additives are used to provide the desirable properties at the interacting surfaces. You can see this is a schematic of two surfaces separated by boundary layer of lubricant. So the lubricant properties and additives are very important to ensure the proper lubrication between two surfaces. So additives play a major role in defining the properties of the lubricants. So if we talk about the good lubrication, a good boundary lubricant should have a high degree of interaction between the molecules and sliding surfaces. And as a general rule, liquids are good lubricants when they are polar and thus able to grip solid surfaces. So if the molecules are polar, it means they have vacancies or attraction for the other atoms, like minus OH in this polar molecule of formalin Z-dol, and this is formalin Z-15, where you don't have any kind of vacancies or attraction for other vacancies for other atoms. So these are non-polymer polar molecules. So if you have a polar molecule in a lubricant, they are referred as good lubricants and they can absorb properly on the solid surfaces. So in case of physiosorption, chemisorption and inorganic film coating on the surfaces, the polarity plays a major role in these two processes of physiosorption, chemisorption and inorganic film creation. You can see there is an adhesive force between the lubricant and the surfaces, and the interatomic forces of cohesion between the interatomic between the atoms of the different lubricants. So the absorption, physiosorption and chemisorption depends on the polarity of the molecules. As far as physical and chemical properties of the lubricants are concerned, this primarily depend on the attributes of the structure of the base stock, and chemical properties are depend formulated lubricants depends on the additives used in the base stock. So physical and chemical property both are important, and the properties which we are interested in are of course viscosity, surface tension, thermal properties, volatility, oxidative stability, thermal stability, hydrolytic stability, gas solubility and inflammability. So these are the properties which are of interest as far as good lubricant is concerned. So additives are used to increase the specific property of some lubricants. So in boundary lubrication, one of the most important property of lubricant is the chemical function or polarity, of course, which governs the ability of lubricant molecule to be physisorbed, chemisorbed or chemically reacted with the surface. This is a very important property. So modified surfaces minimize the damage that can occur in intermittent asperity contacts. So if you add additive between in between 0.1 and 0.5% added to the boundary lubricant, so it will produce a good protective film on the in the boundary lubrication conditions. So lubricants are classified based on the behavior of the additives, which are non-reactive, low friction lubricity and anti-wear and extreme pressure. So these are the properties after additives has been added into lubricants. These are the property which has to be enhanced in case of lubricants, liquid lubricants. So you can enhance these properties using different types of additives, low friction additives, anti-wear additives. And the anti-wear additives are, for example, zinc dialkyl dithiophosphate or ZDDP and organic phosphates such as tricrystyl phosphate, TCP and ethyl stearate. So these are the anti-wear additives. There are some low friction additives of the lubricants which are used to added into the lubricants. As far as greases are concerned, greases are used where circulating liquid lubricant cannot be contained because of space and where cooling by the oil is not required. So when the cooling by the oil is not required and there is a space limitations, and where the liquid lubricant is not lubrication is not feasible, we use greases. So grease is a semi-solid lubricant produced by dispersion of a thickening agent in liquid lubricant, and they may contain other ingredients that impart special properties. So they are the semi-solid lubricants, and they are produced by dispersion of thickening agent in a liquid lubricant. The majority of greases are composed of petroleum and synthetic oils, thickened with metal soaps and other agents such as clay, silica, carbon black and polytetrafluoroethylene, PTFE. So these are the thickening agents for which are mixed into liquid lubricants. Most lubricant greases used in industry have petroleum oils such as their liquid base. So the industrial greases generally use petroleum oil as their base. The petroleum oil based greases can be used at a temperature up to 175 degrees centigrade, depend on the thickener. That is, barium metal soap gives the maximum usable temperature of 175 degrees centigrade. So this has to be remembered. This is the fact that in petroleum based oil, barium metal soaps give higher temperature stability. The synthetic oil based greases can be used at higher temperatures. The best material in these greases are silicones thickened with amyline and silica, and they can be used at temperatures up to 300 degrees centigrade. So synthetic oil based greases are used at higher temperatures, and these are the agents which are used for elevated temperature up to 300 degrees centigrade. So greases are the semi solid lubricants. So thank you students, and we will discuss in next lecture the most important tribological aspect in design. Thank you.